The UDOT Road Asset Viewer, or RAV, is a straight line diagram tool that allows you to identify features along UDOT state routes. The tool provides a two-dimensional map interface for identifying the location of the route while also visually stacking information about the location of features along the route. The tool is available from the UDOT data portal, data.udot.utah.gov, or at this website. Keep in mind that this tool is updated periodically, and the location or name of tools may change, but the overall functionality and purpose of this tool remain the same. Once you are at the RAV tool, the first step is to select the route you are interested in, along with any milepost limits. The default is the whole route, but you can modify them as needed. Note that the route name is the four-digit route as well as the direction, P for positive and N for negative, if applicable. Loading the data layers may take a minute. You can observe the progress in the main window. The selected route will appear in the map pane on the right. The initial zoom extent is the part of the route you selected, but you can then pan and zoom on the map. Keep in mind that the whole route will be highlighted in yellow, not just the segment between the mileposts you have entered. In the map, you can change the base map if you would like. If the segment is too long to fit in your browser window, you may need to scroll to move along the straight line diagram. Hovering over the straight line diagram will show a red line and the associated milepost of your pointer. It will also show an indicator on the map to the nearest tenth of a mile. As you scroll and move along the route, the map will automatically pan to stay centered on the milepost of your pointer. You may also zoom in or out using the map interface, though it does not affect the view in the straight line diagram. To investigate features along the chosen segment, select layers from the pick list and close the window. The location of features in the layer are now stacked underneath the straight line diagram. Information about the features within the area of interest is also provided in the table at the bottom of the window. You can download a copy of the data in the table as a CSV or comma delimited format. Clicking on the straight line diagram will generate a buffered blue line. Now the features in the table will only reflect those that are within the buffered area. The default width of the buffer is 5/100 of a mile, but you can change this parameter in the options menu. Here you can select a buffer size from 5/100 of a mile to 1 mile. Note that the location of the buffer is also presented in the map with a blue circle. The location, again, is rounded to the nearest tenth of a mile. As a reminder, if you export this table to a CSV now, you will only get those features that are within the buffered area. Should you wish to eliminate the buffer, double-click in the straight line diagram. Also note that the features in the table are sorted by the start milepost attribute. If you wish, you can also zoom in or out on the straight line diagram by changing the pixels per mile value in the options. The default value is 200 pixels per mile. You can choose a value between 10 pixels to 1000 pixels per mile. This also affects the scale at which the pointer displays the milepost value. Increasing the number zooms in or increases the resolution, while decreasing the pixels zooms out or decreases the resolution. However, the indicator on the map will still be rounded to the nearest tenth of a mile. Thank you for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, please contact Central GIS.